Yes, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for your presence here this afternoon. And I'm sorry that you will have to work pretty hard again because of the by-election. 我想大家都知道 我们为什么需要有这个补选。 工人党在去年大选的时候 我们的竞选口号是迈向第一世界国会。第一世界国会，我们所期待的最基本的，当然是国会里的议员呢必须肯负责任，必须有透明度。所以呢，当前后港区议员饶兴荣发生的这些事件之后， 而也不出来负责澄清的时候，工人党呢，身为一个负责任、有诚信的政党，做出了这个令人痛苦的决定。所以现在呢，我们面对后港补选，我们会全力以赴 去面对这个风险。As you all know, at the last election, the Workers' Party's campaign slogan was "Towards a First World Parliament," in whichever form the First World Parliament will evolve. I think fundamentally, what's important is that MPs in First World Parliament must have responsibility and must be transparent. Therefore, when the former Member of Parliament for Hougang, Yao Xingrong, failed to account for the allegations made against him about his personal life, the Workers' Party, being a responsible party, value itself to be a party of integrity, had to take the drastic step to expel him from the party. And thereby, here we are, the by-election in Hougang. We will fight the by-election to the best of our ability. And now, I shall introduce you the Workers' Party candidate for Hougang. I believe you already know who he is. It's Png Eng Huat. There's no secret about it. Png Eng Huat is a mature candidate. I hope you don't take it as old. I have known him since before 2006 election. But we did not feel him as a candidate in 2006 because we knew him too short a time at the point in time when we go into the election in 2006. As I told the election committee and some party members, every candidate we feel is a risk because if the PAP managed to dig out anything on the candidate, then you have the whole election campaign zooming in on the problem, and they will fail to move on. So we didn't feel him on 2006. We observed him for quite some time, the way he worked, and we are confident that he's a person of integrity, sincere, wanting to serve the people, and he fixed our criteria as a candidate. And therefore, we feel him at the last election as a candidate at East Coast GRC. And again, in this by-election, the by-election committee has unanimously decided that Png Eng Huat is the right candidate for Hougang by-election. So I now present him to you, and you may ask questions that you have for him.
Thank you for coming. My name is Png Eng Huat. I think I gave an intro just 12 months ago. So some of the things I'll repeat. I am the youngest in a family of six, and I was born in quite a rough neighborhood. Turned out okay. And I am happily married. I have two kids, one 9, one 10, and happy kids, they're all happy kids. And I've been involved in Hougang since 2006, like what Mr. Lau has said. Actually, I was in Hougang to take care of also the welfare side, to take care of the needy resident before they tore down that rental block, the block 3 and block 4. So I work very closely with a lot of VWOs, a couple of them, to bring in food, ration and all those stuff. And also basically just take care of their welfare. And then, like what Mr. Lo said, 2006 I did help out in the back end. So 2011 when I was given the opportunity to stand, I took up the offer. So I didn't know I have to stand again in 12 months time. So so here am I. If you've got any questions, please bio.
The DPM is wrong. We take election very seriously. And the reason why we have to take the drastic step to expel Yaw Shing Leong, I think I explained earlier, and it has actually a broader perspective to that, because Yaw is a member of parliament, he's not just a member of the party. And we believe that it's important for parliament to have responsible MPs. And in any case, the by-election also shows how a democratic system should work. And it shows that the Workers' Party has a political will to put things right if it goes wrong. It is not easy to remove an MP from the party. I'm sure you know about that. And we have never taken the decision lightly. And Dave, I don't quite understand what he means by trivializing the, you know, the electoral system. And of course, the electoral system is a tool of the best person to be in parliament. So if a party finds that he's not the right person, although he's elected, it is correct for the party to follow the electoral process of the system, and thereby voters in Hougang had another opportunity to decide what is the best MP for them. So we have never trivialized. On the contrary, we take it seriously and we are working the system well.
I got one more question to answer. Just so. I wouldn't like to speculate on the chances, the percentage, but this is a first past the post system. Simple majority to me is a mandate.
Yes.
Hi.
DPM
government also said this by-election would be a local election, and that national matters wouldn't, you know, be the focus that much, and that Hougang residents would be looking at more hyper-local issues to win the award. Do you agree?
Want to answer the question?
Well, basically, you will know when we go into the by-election proper, what issue you bring up, whether it's national, whether it's local. But I believe that it can never be so clear-cut whether it's local or national. Whilst we have noted DPM's comment on what the PAP want to do, But we have to see what does it come out, you know, before we respond to whether it's local or national. But I believe it can never be issues equally or just local, you know, per se.
Hi, this by-election is being held in the backdrop of several sex scandals, or alleged sex scandals. We have the CID chief, former CID chief, the SCDF chief, and we have this court case. So how do you think this number of cases is going to colour the by-election? number of sex scandals that Singaporeans have had to face, along with the one with that Mr. Yaw Shin Leong was allegedly involved in. How is he going to colour the election?
Well, I don't think our election want to go down to the level of personal level at the first place. I think basically, we are human beings, there's a human weakness, and things can happen not only in political party and not only in workers' parties, and it can happen anywhere. So, but I don't think we want to go into that, you know, the area.我们一向来都有很严格的遴选标准，而最重要一点呢，就是我们经过一段时间了解一个人之后，我们再决定他是不是应该成为候选人。不论是姚新荣，不论是方先生或其他候选，基本上我们都有这样的一个遵照这样的一个原则。但是没有一样用遴选标准呢是万无一失的，人。 终归还是人，所以呢，我们可以肯定，就是我们问心无愧的，就是我们并不随便让任何人成为工人党候选人，我们有一定的审查、观察标准跟遴选制度。 No, I will see it as a by-election in Hougang. I thought you all should ask some more question of the candidate, right? How come?
Is there a party? Is there a slogan for your campaign?
No, we don't have a slogan, but I will continue the legacy that's left by Mr. Low.
So, can you elaborate on why voters should choose you over Mr. Desmond Chu? He's campaigning on this all this here for you.
We've been.
And he said that it reflects the fact that he's going to be there for the long term, right? And the residents can count on him. What have you got to offer?
Oh, we have been there since 1991, so we have been there for them, and we want to continue that. And most important is to the voters of Hougang, I wish to continue to represent them in Parliament, to be their voice. To voice their concern, which the Workers' Party has done so for the past 20 years.
Mr. Pang, both you and Mr. Chu are sort of untested candidates. Neither of you have really led a town council before. So what is it that you're offering residents, or why should they trust you?
Why should they trust me?
Or vote for
I think the town council, if you look at it, is managed by professionals. Okay, so what I would say is that I'm a fast learner. Okay. No issue about managing town, so I learned by actually I talked to the town council manager almost every other day since
I think you may have posed the question to the wrong person. The chairman of town council is here.
So not an issue. I won't see that as a problem.